Hello everyone, this is Ronnie. Hope you're having a good day. This is my fruit festival hat. And what I want to talk about today is a reason that apparently it's the biggest reason that people don't stick to a raw vegan diet or fail on it. However you want to define fail. And this came from something from Rick and Karen Dina. So Rick and Karen Dina have been raw vegan primarily for 25 years, and they teach the science of raw and the science of nutrition and things connected to that. I think they were at various institutes and places where they taught it. I don't know exactly. But you can check their website for their information. And they have a thing called Mastering Raw Nutrition. I've never taken the course yet. I think I'd be quite interested to do that course. I've not done that yet, but you can have a look at that and see if that's something. Apparently, it's very good. So, one thing that they said, because on their website you can get like a free book. So I was looking through this book, and it said the biggest reason that people fail after they've went, there was a study, actually an actual study was done. The biggest that people don't continue on the raw diet after they've been to like a course or a seminar or like they've been to a raw food institute or whatever. The biggest reason that they, or the biggest, so if you put it the other way, the biggest thing that predicted their success and that they were going to continue to do it long term was the level of education the person had about the raw vegan diet. So the biggest thing that predicted their success was their level of education. And what that really means is that if someone didn't know anything about it, hadn't really researched it, hadn't really read about it, and just went to try this 1 week raw course or whatever, the chances of them sticking to it were quite low. But the person who'd researched it, they were into it, they'd read a lot of books and looked into it before, and had a lot of information, they were going to succeed long term and stick to it long term. And the reason that I bring this up is because it really resonates with me. It really resonates with me because I spent a lot of time researching and learning this diet and lifestyle. And I've been to the festivals, and the festivals, if you use them properly, there's a lot of education to be had from going to the classes and the lectures, going to the Q&A sessions, speaking to the teachers, speaking to the different people. And you can get a lot out of that, especially if you go multiple times. And hopefully at the UK Fruit Fest, we really put education as one of the highest priority things. Some festivals don't have any speakers. Some festivals and events have got rid of a lot of their speakers. Some of them maybe just have one speaker or one particular person, or it might be just one like retreat and it's just one person's perspective. But I really value the education of the UK Fruit Fest. I think it's a very important thing. I don't believe that people can get all this information from YouTube. They kind of could if they were lucky and found all the right videos, potentially, and then studied those videos. But people aren't really doing that. They're looking for the drama and the this and the that and the magical thinking and the things that they want to believe, you know? So education is a really important part of it. And what I've found over the years going to these events is that I would see people like myself going to a lot of the lectures, and I'd see other people not going to them. And I'd see other people maybe going to a few and then they didn't go to the rest. And those are the people that, to me, have never stuck to the diet. So the people that never went to the lectures, never really listened, I guess they weren't really that interested in the first place, potentially. But they just wanted to hang out and meet people and go for the connections. And a lot of people say to me, I go to the festival for the connections and to meet people. And I value that, and I totally value the connections and the people. But the first year I went, I wanted the education and the information. Really, I really genuinely believe that was one of the big draws for me, was not necessarily the connection with all the other people, but the connection to the speakers and the teachers and the information and that knowledge. And Some people have said to me, I don't understand that. Like some people said to me they don't understand why you'd go to Woodstock when you can go to Thailand and eat fruit or something like that. To me, there's just much more value in Woodstock every single time. There's way more value in a week of Woodstock than a month of or 2 months of Thailand, to me. Still, and now I don't go to so many of the lectures, and I think I still should, but I've developed more of my own perspective on this based on my own. So I know some of the speakers. I've seen some of their stuff already. A lot of them I've already seen multiple times. I've seen the talk that they're going to give. So when I think about my time, do I want to play soccer or do I want to go to a talk that I've already seen? Well, I really want to go and play soccer with my friends. I love playing. We call it football. I think they call it football over at Woodstock, really, but I'm saying soccer because everyone understands that word. So now I'm at a position as 6 years sort of raw vegan, where I'm not really maybe needing to go to the lecture so much, but I still want to learn more. I would, if people really upped their game and they did some really advanced lectures, I would go along to them. Some of the people's perspectives at Woodstock I don't like. Some of them I don't agree with. Some of them I don't like their information, or I don't think they're a good presenter. So I don't go along. If someone's a bad presenter, it's like, to me, it's like a really poor waste of the audience's time, But I do value the education. And there's people at Woodstock that come up and ask me questions, or not just Woodstock, but any festival, any raw vegan event. They'll ask me questions, and I'm thinking, how do you not know that already? How do you not know the answer to this? And the reason is they never bothered to go to any of the lectures. To me, it's an educational event primarily, but with Woodstock, it tends to be that a lot of people are going there as just a lifestyle thing now, what'd you call it? Kind of like meeting people, hanging out. They've met a lot of great friends there, so they're going back every year to see these awesome friends, and it is a lot of awesome people. And I love that part of it as well. More and more, I love that part of it. And when I left the first year, that was what I got a lot out of. But the education for me is the thing that's created the foundation of my raw diet, and being able to ask the questions. I've been able to figure out even silly things like, is it okay for me to make a smoothie and then put it in the fridge and then drink it the next day? Silly things like that, were things that I was asking the first year, and trying to confirm what I'd seen online and trying to watch people as they ate. And now I know all that stuff, and now I believe that I'm in a position where the amount of research I've done that I'm really solid in that. So if someone challenges me, there's these people going on the carnivore diet now. It's just a lack of education. That's all it is, I'm telling you. There is no way that you would do the carnivore diet if you fully understood the impact of eating meat. And I'm not talking about environmentally or to the animals. I mean to your body. And to be honest, there's probably no way that you would continue to be happy with eating cooked food if you really realize the impact to your body and really understood that and really felt that and were really honest with yourself. And it kind of disappoints me coming out of events that everyone, this like a beeline, people like rushing towards the vegan restaurant, the vegan pizza place. There was a guy saying to me, hey, we do an annual burrito run. How about you come with us for the burrito run? And I'm like, I'm not going to leave this festival after I've spent 7 days eating perfectly, surrounded by fantastic nature, amazing lake, fresh air, beautiful people. Like, I'm having the best time, and then go and eat burritos and just destroy it. Like, why would I do that? Why would I take myself up to this level and then burrito myself down to that level? Like, so to me, it's crazy to me. And I know that there's people that go back to eating cooked food, but why wouldn't you at least give yourself a couple of weeks, give yourself a month? Like, allow that momentum of the festival to keep you going And for those people that already decide, you know, that's me going raw now. But yeah, I'm kind of disappointed with people doing that. But it's a lack of education. Like, it's not going to the lectures, it's not learning, it's not having that passion. It's forgetting really why you ever came into this in the first place. It certainly wasn't because you were happy with the cooked food diet or happy with the cooked vegan diet. There's no way that people were. So education is important, but the first stage of the education is not going raw and raw is good and why raw is good, and that's where I think we can make some improvements at these festivals. The first thing is to take a person and say the standard diet isn't good for you, and here's why. Or maybe the first thing before that is to say you should actually consider getting healthy. Like, being healthier is a good idea. Being healthier is a good idea. It's going to have an impact, good impact on you and on your life. Because there's a lot of people that aren't convinced yet that even they should make any kind of step forward. And there's people that are going to Woodstock and UK Fruit Fest and other events, and they're not even vegan. Some people I know have been to these events for years. They're not vegan, they're not vegetarian, they're not eating a healthy, even a healthy standard diet, even a whole food standard diet. They go away and I see them on Instagram or whatever, or Facebook, and they're like in some cut, like, I don't know, eating chicken curry or something, or like just stuff. I'm like, how do they end up at Woodstock or some other thing? I don't think that's a good choice for them, but it's a lack of education, right? So we start with the thing like, maybe you shouldn't do that. Maybe junk food's a bad idea. Maybe health is a good thing to move towards. And then if health's a good thing to move towards, the standard diet is not supporting your health, and here's why. And then you should really go vegan. If you want to get healthier, you should go vegan. Here's why you should go vegan. And if you want to really go to optimal health, you should go raw. And here's all the reasons you should go raw and why it's much better and why fruit is the best food. And then here's the next stage of going raw. If you want to do it long term, here's what you have to do to go long term. Here's specifically how to go raw. And then by the end of the festival, you've maybe got to a point where you're given a little bit of like lifestyle information and things about, you know, exercise and sleep and getting fresh air and can you get enough on a raw diet and all these kind of important issues. But you've taken a person on that journey from here's the education about why you should get healthy. Here's information about why you shouldn't do the standard diet. Here's information why you should go vegan. Here's and cover that all off so that when the person leaves that festival and they can't now take that journey right back to here, to where they were, they cannot go on that journey anymore. You see? So they might say to themselves, oh, I'd really love to go to McDonald's, but they're saying, wait a minute, I've been told that I'm convinced now that I should be healthy and I shouldn't do that. I'm convinced the standard diet's bad. I'm convinced that I should be vegan. I'm convinced that I should go raw. I'm convinced that I've learned how to go raw, and I've learned all, that there's no downsides or negatives to going raw or whatever. And by that point, you've really solidly padded that person up with information so that their chances of going back are less. Some people will find their way back and find their own little path, but you've given a straight road for the most people to follow. And I think that that's people are missing these stages. They've not convinced themselves that veganism is the best thing. They've not convinced themselves that even health, like, they think that going and hanging out with their friends, taking drugs and going back to that lifestyle, like that's more valuable, the friendships and the family and all that. But you can have both, but they think that they want to go right back to that. There's people that think raw isn't good enough, or there's no difference in raw. The amount of people that go to some of these events, Woodstock in particular, and they don't think that raw's better, and they're like, I'm never going raw again. I'm like, why are you even here? Do you not understand this is a raw vegan festival? Like, what the? I mean, everyone's welcome, right? Everyone's welcome, but I'm like, that's a weird statement. It's like, why would I, like, I wouldn't go to the carnivore conference or something, or the paleo group, and then be like, I'm never going paleo, but I just want to hang out with some people that want to get healthy. Like, I don't know. I don't like, and once again, if a person comes to Woodstock purely for the people, then I appreciate that because they're supporting that event. But they've got to ask themselves, why are those people coming, and what is it that's making those come in, and what is it that makes those people special? Is it not the fact that they're eating, that they're the kind of person that is willing to eat raw, you know? So I people are lacking education, and I would advise reading the 80-10-10 book, and Rick and Karen Dina, have a look at some of their stuff. I've been to some of their lectures, and you know, it's a lot of people, but you need to convince yourself that veganism is definitely better. If you're not convinced by that yet, you've just not done the research. I'm talking about the health side of it. You've not done the research. And there is, you know, the keto diet, the carnivore diet, these are horrible diets. Like, these are the worst diets ever. It doesn't matter, you see a person with a testimonial out there. You can do anything for a week or 2 weeks and think that it's better. So don't fall for that nonsense. Like, oh no, I'll be better if I do the carnivore diet. Like, it's crazy. It's a terrible, terrible diet, right? Paleo diet, all they're horrendous diets. If you've not done the research, you need to see that they've got nothing backing what they're saying, right? Why is raw better? Well, you can see the downsides to cooked food. There's all sorts of downsides to cooked food. I would like to research that more. To be honest, I've been convinced to go raw through the testimonials of other people, through some fairly, what seemed to me, fairly logical arguments based on, well, you know, other animals don't eat raw, so don't eat cooked food, so why are we eating cooked food, and so on and so forth. And then experience it myself, and that's what made me go raw, and meeting other people that did it, that's what made me do it. But I would like to start putting some more science underneath me, more and more, so that when I can come across people that want that science, I can give them the science. But if you want the science on plant-based and veganism, then we can shove that down your throat all day long because it's so kind of extensive there. Anyway, I'm really happy to be back doing these videos. I hope that you want to see more. I want to do like a raw pizza weekend or party or something up here in Glasgow if you want to come up and hang out. And it's probably not going to be something you'll really pay for, maybe pay towards the ingredients. But in that sense, probably won't be offering any accommodation. If it would be good to offer some accommodation, then maybe we can work out trying to find some accommodation, rent a place, charge people. Then it becomes a whole event again, like the UK Fruit Fest, and then you can't just charge the cost of it. You have to charge a bit more because someone's going to come and then cancel, and then someone's going to ask for a refund or something, and then someone's going to whatever, you know. All of a sudden you have to put the price up and all this stuff. So and you have to promote it, and you have to try and fill it, otherwise you so we could do it like that, or just simple. You can get your own accommodation, come up, and we'll do like a kind of, and that's the hook is trying to get is the raw pizza, but we're really gonna be eating a lot of fruit, right? So but there'll be some pizza. So fruitfest.co.uk, if you want to get the free recipe book, you can. If you want to promote the event, feel free to share the stuff about the event. Go to our blog. You can subscribe to this channel, share this video with others. Ask me a question down below, comment down below. Do you feel you've got enough education? And I want to start coaching as well. If you'd like some information on that, feel free to get in touch with me. I'm going to start doing coaching because I'm kind of concerned about the level of information that's going out there and the level of coaching and stuff. So I want to volunteer or offer myself out there to help people. So thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed the video. This is going to be regular. Going to put more videos out. Glad to reconnect with everyone. You're going to see more from me. Thank you very much for following the channel, and we'll see you later. Thank you.